Hi everyone. In today episode, I would like to talk about one of my favorite fictional universe known as Sexy Space Babes. What is this universe about? Well, it's actually pretty unique if you think about it from one perspective, but I would tell about this later, maybe in future episodes. I don't know, I don't really give a fuck. In today's episode I would like to do something really important to the human race, but first I would like to introduce you to the whole concept of Sexy Space Babes. So what the Sexy Space Babes is about? Sexy Space Babes is web novel created by so-called user BlueFishcake on on Reddit, but you can also find this web novel on Royal Road. In his web novel, Earth was invaded by a race of sexy purple orc Amazons known as Shilvanti. Shilvanti invaded Earth for two reasons. First is that they are just like that, they are extensionist empire. The second is because humans and Earth by extent have really important material known as men. Yes, you hear me right, material known as men. You see, in this universe, almost all races have really weird gender ratio, one man to eight women. Some have like one man to six women, but mostly women outnumber men, except in Earth, when we humans have one man to one woman gender ratio. So Shilvanti basically want to make Earth a really big paradise island. That's a life. In the web novel, main protagonist was forced to join their military when he beat one of the Shilvanti in drunken rage. I would like to celebrate this web novel by making really important thing to human culture. What it is, you ask? Well, it's all good objectifying women. Let's be all honest. We cannot have humanity without objectifying women. So we can as well objectify some sexy space babes from Sexy Sex Babes by Blue Fish Cake. So first objectification material we have, Shilvanti women. What we know about Shilvanti women? Shilvanti are a race of purple orc Amazon. They basically a race of supermodels. They have their own empire, go figure. Shilvanti empire is known from two things. Shilvantis, and that the empire is basically matriarchal feudal queendom ruled by the Shilvanti empress. No one know what's a matriarch of the empire name is. Shilvanti have low stamina, but they have enormous strength. Well, you can see they are basically orcs from space, but purple. But one thing about Shilvanti society is that they are basically basic. What I mean by basic? Well, Shilvanti society, except of that they are still a feudal monarchy, they don't really differentiate so much from human society. So if humans have this, probably Shilvanti also have this, except from freedom of speech. But let's be honest here, only few humans have real freedom of speech, so this really don't make change for the half of the human population. But they are not only basic, they are unfortunately also bitches. And what they are mean by bitches? So let's be honest, Shilvanti are just arrogant, obnoxious women. And I do not joke. The power of Shilvanti arrogancy is so great that only the biggest YouTubers can have bigger egos than your standard Shilvanti. Therefore, they are just bitches. Basic bitches. Verdict? B minus. B because they're basic. Minus because they're bitches. Go fucking figure. Next on our objectifying train is our Rakiri. Rakiri, as you can see, are fully bait in this universe. They were conquered by Shilvanti something like 200 years before the book starts. In their society, hunting is like war for humans, which means this is very important thing to them. Rakiris are actually different from most of sexy space babe societies because they actually respect men. Why they are respecting of men so much? You see, typical Rakiri is a murder werewolf. They can simply rip everything apart with their claws. So if typical Rakiri is a murder werewolf, male Rakiri is a miniature murder werewolf. He can be dangerous to everything he thinks is dangerous to him. So they must kind of respect men if they don't want to be jumped by the men. They are actually kind of stalky. Their society grant men pretty much freedom of moving freely, but still they stalk their man of choice, and it's kind of a sign of the affection. Don't ask me why, I actually don't know either. They are kind of now grants of the Shilvanti because they are stronger, bigger, and sometimes even meaner than typical Shilvanti. But what is cool about them is that they are not as arrogant, and you actually can have a generous conversation with a member of this species. They are actually pretty cool. The only thing I cannot stand by is that they are furries, but you can have a weird, non-usual science fiction story without furries these days, so I don't even complain that much. But still, furries. Oh, and they like cold, like they like Alaska cold. Antarctica cold. So, life. I told I furries, aren't I? Anyway, verdict is A plus. Why? Even though they are furries, all Rakiris are good girls, and all Rakiri men are good boys. Remember that. Next we have Helcam. What are Helcam? Helcam are fish people with pitchfork tongues and they are cold-blooded. We don't really have much of information about Helcam, but what we can know is that they have a really weird caste system based on skin color. And as a human, I cannot stand for this. I would rather have a caste system based on skills and based on your ladder in the spiritual world. Well, sorry. But anyway, Helcams are B tier because they are not as bad as Shilvanti are, but they also are not as good as Rahiri. So they are B. Next, on our objectifying non-stop choo-choo train, we have Nikru. Nikru aren't part of the Imperium. They have their own trade coalition. They are basically a drows with growing eyes and weird algae symbiotic tattoos. They also are extremely capitalist and their society is really cut-throwing. They are also a slavers and they are black. So yeah. Moving on, verdict is D plus. D because they are seen as fan favorite in the community, but D because they are slavers, not because they are black. Yeah, moving on. Moving on, we have Tricky. Tricky are moffed people with venomous teeth. But when I say venomous teeth, well, their teeth are not actually teeth. Their teeth are actually venom holders. They just hold them like camels, but instead of the back, they are hold the venom on their chests. And they probably have even weirder caste systems than Helcam. And they probably migrate or something. I don't know. We don't really have that much information on Tricky. Moving on. Verdict is none because we just don't have that much information, just like I said. And I don't feel comfortable talking about their venomous teeth. Yeah, moving on. Next, we have Urfrian. They are blue-skinned Bronze Age civilization, cosplaying Greek hoplites, and they like to steal. Why they are like to steal? Because they are Bronze Age civilization subjugated by multiracial, multi-galactic empire of Shilvanti. So they kinda need to steal to survive. Also, their homeworld is a one big storm rock where nothing grows on the top of the planet, so they must live in cages. And yes, they are this weird guy from Star Wars. I don't really like Star Wars extended family. You know, the Admiral Trunks, or how was he? I don't really know. I much prefer Warhammer. Verdict C. I don't remember why I give them Verdict C. No, I remember. Because they are one of the sexiest species in the universe. And they also like to steal. I would give them A if they wasn't so much stealing normalized in their society. Last but A not least, we finally have human woman. Let's be honest, We all were waiting to objectify some old, good human woman. Well, human woman in this universe are basically equivalent of every other race men. So they are sometimes referred to as men in woman bodies. They are actually one of the sexiest females in the universe, at least in the eyes of their respected females from other races. They are kind of salty because a multiracial empire just go after human men. So they are now salty because of this, but they are actually going kinda along other species men, if they find any. But let's be honest, look how cute the female specimen I present to you is here. We still kinda love them, aren't we? And the verdict for human woman is A+, and simultaneously F. Why? Well, because all human women are queen. So A+, but they also are tots, aren't they? Aren't they? So F because they are tots and A+ because they are queen. But if woman wants to still be queen, she just need to don't breed. And then she is all the time A+, because no man want to have thought in their sheets. Aren't they? Aren't they? Anyway, that's all for today. See you soon in the new video. If you like, leave the like. If you like, leave the subscription. If you don't like, don't. I don't really give a fuck. Have a nice day. Okay.